Hello everyone, welcome to Newsline. Saki, Trump and GOP have one night to get their act together. Jen Saki, a political commentator, was the White House communications director and State Department spokeswoman during the Obama administration. She is vice president of communications and strategy at the Carnegie Endowment for International Peace. Follow her at Jen Saki. The opinions expressed in this commentary are solely those of the author. Follow S coverage of the State of the Union at 9 p.m. EST on Tuesday. Our expectations have sunk so low that a major victory for the Trump team at the State of the Union speech on Tuesday night would consist of the president successfully walking down a long hallway and then reading for an hour from prepared remarks without going off script. If he can accomplish those two things, you can anticipate that the speech will be lauded by many pundits and commentators as a bright moment in his presidency and a possible turning point. After all, Trump will be entering the chamber with an approval rating hovering in the high 30s. And hovering over that is an ongoing investigation of many of his advisers and possibly himself by special counsel Robert Mueller, the resignation Monday of the deputy director of the FBI, Andrew McCabe, whom Trump has publicly derided, and a House Intelligence Committee vote to release a controversial partisan memo that accuses the FBI of misusing the Foreign Intelligence Surveillance Act. Despite the opposition of the Department of Justice, Trump has said he's inclined to release it. In summary, he is facing some serious headwinds. The test for Trump and the White House is not whether he can read from a teleprompter and look presidential, but whether he and his team have the discipline and the capacity to use this as a moment to reset. Here are the three real questions the White House should be judged on. Thanks for watching video, subscribe our channel for latest news.